Good evening and welcome to our 2023 Spring Choral Concert. It's a bit of a new format for us. We have tonight our middle school, our two middle school groups and our two high school groups. So you get to see a full night of choral singing, lots of beautiful music, some fun music, some different tunes, and our sixth graders are kicking us off tonight. So in the spring with our middle school groups, and with Vox as well, we try to center our music around a theme. And so with that theme, they self-chose, we kind of worked through this whole long process, right? And we settled on Inside Out. Not like your shirt's on Inside Out, but the movie Inside Out, which centers around kind of these different emotions living and existing inside the mind of a teenage girl. So you have joy. And that was our first emotion, happy, joy, right? Makes sense. The other emotions are anger and sadness, who we'll also hear from, so to speak. And there's fear and disgust, but we chose to bypass those. It's kind of hard to find good songs about fear and disgust, nor would we necessarily want to hear them. But we decided that maybe joy has a cousin, and that cousin is pride, being proud, right? And so that is our final song of this set. So that was Happy, originally by Pharrell Williams. Our next song is Rolling in the Deep, and by Adele. It kind of expresses those angry emotions. And we have two soloists, Jeanette and Bryden. This is Rolling in the Deep.
Open double.
And let's get an extra special round of applause for our two soloists, Jeanette and Bryden. Our next song covers the sadness emotion. And rather than just singing a sad song and getting you all in a bummed out mood right away in our concert, we're kind of doing a twist on it. So this song, Smile, originally by Charlie Chaplin, it's an older song, but has been sung by many, many, many other artists. Nat King Cole, it was on Glee. And so this song is words of encouragement you might give to someone who is experiencing sadness. So this is Smile by Charlie Chaplin. We also have a duet in this one, and so Liam and Johnny will be singing for us at the top of this one. This is Smile by Charlie Chaplin. And one more extra special round of applause for Liam and Johnny. So before we do our final song for the sixth grade, spring is a time that we get to give out some awards. And the sixth graders voted on these awards for their peers. And so each one has a different set of criteria. I'll go over it this time, and then it'll apply to the next couple sets of awards. But our first award is the Scarecrow Award. And it goes to someone who is outstanding in their field. It's okay, it's not that great of a pun. All right. But the sixth graders selected for the Scarecrow Award, Jeanette. The next award is the Turtle Award, and this award is given to someone who the students thought really came out of their shell this year. They don't get better, really. If you're waiting for it to get better, it's not going to happen. So the Turtle Award, the sixth graders voted on, this year goes to Bryden.
Congratulations.
And lastly, it's one award, but there was a tie. This is called the Unsung Singer Award. So if you've heard the expression unsung hero, that's someone who does good without always getting recognized for it. And so our Unsung Singer Award goes to someone who is a positive leader in our choir, does what they're asked to, goes above and beyond, and is just a strong leader for our group and doesn't always get the recognition in that sense. So we have a tie. Our two unsung singers for sixth grade are Liam and Maya. So as I mentioned before, we had joy, we had anger, we had sadness, and now we skip fear and disgust, and we go to kind of the cousin of joy, which would be pride or being proud. And so they selected, this one kind of took us a little bit to figure out what song we were going to do. And then I received an email from one of the students say, hey, what about this song? And I went, sounds like a good idea. I asked the group, they agreed. So our final song for the sixth graders, I'm Still Standing by Elton John, or you may recognize it from the movie Sing. We have just a moment for our change over here between sixth grade and seventh and eighth grade. That's fine. So, sixth grade, fantastic. They did such a great job. What's really encouraging, if you saw all the gentlemen we had up here, man, they were singing so great. I hope they stick with it because we always need more guys in choir. And they were out singing the girls a little bit sometimes. Yeah. So they were doing a great job. Super encouraging to have. And especially some of our soloists and duet people were gentlemen as well. So really appreciative. And they made my job really easy. I don't know if you noticed, I didn't have to wave my arms around too much. I just kind of started the track and let them go for it. So they really prepared hard, and I'm appreciative of that. So we're going to welcome the 7th and 8th grade on here when they are ready. All right, we're going to do something a little different. Instead of filing out here in a nice single file line, they're going to come out to some music. If you know it, feel free to sing along. You'll see what I mean.
Is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling, all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said,
"All right, be honest, how many of you knew it? How many of you were like mumbling it under your breath?" Yeah, yeah. Now, this could go one of two ways. You have the answer in your program, but we could have done TV themes. They lobbied for us to do the theme song from Sophia the First. I vetoed. But the theme for the 7th and 8th graders is royal. Royalty. All things that you can associate with royal. So, that was the theme song from the Fresh Prince of Bel Air. You're getting it. You're getting it. So I'm going to welcome out Mr. Noah McKay and my teaching assistant for 8th period, Alex Lindegard. And they're going to help me out on this first song titled Soldier, Poet, King.
Thank you.
Next up on our royal-themed portion of the concert, we have Everybody Wants to Rule the World, naturally, by Tears for Fears. All right, our next song on the docket we have, appropriately titled, King, written by Lauren Aquilina. It's a beautiful ballad that I didn't know prior to this process. We're looking, as you can imagine, when we're looking for songs to fit a theme, and we're like just Google searching, songs with King, songs with Prince, songs with so on and so forth, songs by Prince, you know, whatever would fit the bill. And we came across this song, and it happens to have just a beautiful message. I encourage you to look it up when you get home as well. Hopefully you'll be able to understand the words. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge. Clearly enunciating our words. But it really focuses a lot on just kind of someone kind of in the depths of their despair and how they can get out of it and can wear their crown again and be king again. So this is King by Lauren Aquilina.
Forgotten what you have been, what is yours?
right, just like the sixth grade, we have awards for seventh and eighth grade. They're the same awful puns, so let's get to it. So, our Scarecrow Award, again, voted on by the 7th and 8th grade choir students. Our Scarecrow Award for being outstanding in their field. I should note this is a singing-based award. It's them recognizing the singing talent of their fellow choir members. So the Scarecrow Award goes to Cora Denure. The Turtle Award, for someone who's come out of their shell, goes to Anya Burke. And the Unsung Singer Award goes to Gracie Schmidt. Now, there are two extra awards that they didn't know about, because they're selected by me. And so these are for eighth graders specifically. And we begin with the Conbrio Award, which roughly translated means with spirit. And so the Conbrio Award honors a single eighth grade choir student who embodies the musical concept Conbrio, or with spirit, by spreading positivity with their words, actions, energy, attitude, and demeanor. And the eighth grader receiving the Conbrio Award this year, Trinity Denreuter. And lastly, we have the Director's Award. So chosen by the director. The Director's Award for Choir honors a single eighth grade student that displays exceptional musical and leadership abilities. And this year, our Director's Award goes to Braxton Soldner. So this last one needs a little explanation. I don't know if you've been perusing your program. You maybe saw Royal, yeah, King Works, or Everybody Wants to Rule the World, Soldier, Poet, King. What on earth does Crazy Train have to do with Royal? Well, let me tell you, because they asked the same question. This is one that I kind of had to choose. So, Crazy Train is by Ozzy Osbourne, who is known as the Prince of Darkness. It's a stretch, but it works. And it's a high-energy way to end our portion of the program. So we have a soloist, a duet, and a quartet in this song. And so I'm going to hand out these mics here. So please enjoy Crazy Train.
That's how it goes. Millions of people living as foes. Maybe it's not too late to learn how to love and forget how to hate. Thank you. I've listened to preachers, I've listened to fools. I've watched all the dropouts who make their own moves. One person conditioned to rule and control. The media sells it, and you live the role.
While Vox is getting set here, I'll give you the spiel kind of all at once so we can just keep the concert rolling. So, Vox chose the theme of nostalgia. But it's not what they're nostalgic about. If we chose what they were nostalgic about, we'd be hearing all 2000s and newer music. All right, that's just the reality of it. That's when they were born. We won't say how old that makes us all feel. But they chose the idea of nostalgia. So when you long for something, when you pine for something, when you're thinking about the past. And so their songs all reflect that theme. They begin with In My Life by the Beatles. They then move on to Telephone Line by Electric Light Orchestra, or ELO. After that, they have By Way of Sorrow in the style of the Waylon Jennings. Not to be confused with Waylon Jennings. And their last piece is Some Nights by the band Fun. That's not just an editorial comment in your program that the song is fun. That's the name of the band. So we're going to let Vox get set here. They will also have some awards somewhere in there. And as they're finishing getting set, I did challenge them. I said, you can pick two songs that are newer, but then you must pick two songs that are older. And they picked some really great songs. We got Beatles, ELO, what more could you ask for? So we begin with In My Life.
All these places had their moments.
All right, now we have awards for Vox. I'm going to turn these over so there's no peeking at the next ones. So our Scarecrow Award for Vox, for someone being outstanding in their field, an exceptional singer as recognized by their peers, goes to Bianca Severo. The Turtle Award for Vox, as presented by their peers, for coming out of their shell, goes to Evian. And lastly, our Unsung Singer Award, for being a positive leader in our choir, the unsung hero of our choir, goes to Lori Jean Wilson. All right, we have one more song for Vox here. And actually, fun fact, it was supposed to be the first song of their portion of the concert, but they were doing so great with it, we decided, let's end with a bang. So this is Some Nights by the band Fun.
Some nights I stay up cashing in my bad luck. Some nights I call it a draw. Some nights I wish that my lips could build a castle. Some nights I wish they'd just fall off. But I still wake up, I still see a ghost. Oh Lord, I'm still not sure what I stand for. Oh, what do I stand for? What do I stand for? Most nights I don't know anymore.
So it's going to take just a few minutes for our Canto Bello folks. We have a lot who do double duty. They're in Vox and Canto Bello, so they got to get robes on. So we're just going to have a little chat again. I'll introduce kind of all the Canto, first I want to talk about Vox, because A, they sounded great. They sounded fantastic. Here's the thing about that group. They are billed as the less formal, more casual choir, just sing for fun. And yet, in that last song, they're singing four-part harmony, all learned by ear. They didn't have sheet music when they were learning this, but we challenged them. Instead of, we could have done all of our songs unison or all singing the same melody, kind of glorified karaoke. But no, they wanted a challenge. They accepted a challenge. And so a lot of our stuff was in three parts, and that last one had four parts going on. So I'm very proud of that group and all that they were able to accomplish this year, even just from winter concert to this concert. So they put in lots of hard work. Make sure you recognize your students who are in Vox. Let's give them one more big round of applause. I'm going to break with tradition a little bit. Normally I save my thank yous until later, but since we're killing time, I'm going to do the thank yous now. They're in the back of the program, but I do want to give a verbal shout out to our administration. We are thankful for a supportive administration here. Our middle school, high school principal, Mr. Tim Biro, our middle school, high school assistant principal, Ms. Marsh Modaff, and our district administrator, Mrs. Jessica Johnson. So we thank the district administration for their continued support of our programs, especially for being willing to shift around kind of the status quo of when our concerts fell in order to make this so we weren't having to switch over between band and choir. There's still transition time, but it's going much smoother. We also want to thank our Dodgeland custodial staff, specifically Jerry Jornes. He was in here after school setting up all these chairs for us. And tomorrow night after our band concert, that's right, you heard it here first, there's a band concert tomorrow night, 7 p.m., same spot, if you want to come listen to some more great music. But after that, the custodial staff will tear it all down. So we thank them for turning this elementary school gym into a performance space several times a year. So, and it's no easy task. And then lastly, I did this at the elementary concert, but I'm going to do it again because it bears repeating. A big debt of gratitude that we have for Mr. Brad Modaff and all he does to make sure that we sound and look as good as we do. Our multipurpose room just got a big upgrade of our lighting and sound system and also new curtains. And so the stage was refreshed and the new lighting really adds to the overall concert experience. The sound is great. I hope you're noticing that too out there. And so he puts in a lot of extra hours to make sure that everything goes smoothly. And so a great big thank you to Brad Modaff as well. Yes, and let's round of applause.
That was our first piece, Come Travel With Me, written by Scott Farthing. Walt Whitman's Song of the Open Road is the basis for the free-spirited lyrics that beckon you to come travel with us on the journey of our spring concert.
Our second song is Bring Me Little Water, Sylvie, arranged by Adam Pod. It is an American folk song that has a steady groove provided by the sounds of the cajon, an upright bass, and the piano. Our seniors start the song, and then everyone joins in, and there is a solo done by Carly Nails. This song makes us all feel energetic, and we love the sound of it, and we hope you do too.
We're going to take a moment to do awards for Cantobello at this point, rather than after our next song, which is a slower, perhaps more emotional song. So, with Cantobello, same sort of format, different words, and we're going to pass the mic off to Carly and Becca to give out the peer selected awards.
And the Bravura Award is awarded to Zoe Amos.
And the Crescendo Award is awarded to Sarah Benzing.
The Maestro Award is awarded to Carly Nails.
And the Maestro Award is also awarded to Sam Walsh for being a leader in the choir.
So those were a lot of fancy Italian words. Real quick, bravura, kind of like brava or bravo, awarded for musical skill and talent. Zoe was at her district solo ensemble, got a score, qualified for state, and so very proud of her accomplishment this year in choir. Our crescendo award for someone who grew this year in choir, and while Sarah's always been a little outgoing, she really grew, I feel, in her musicianship and her leadership, especially without her partner in crime, Emma, here every day in choir. She kind of took charge in the alto section. And then our Maestro Award. Maestro is someone who conducts, and so outstanding in their conduct and their leadership for our group was Carly and Sam. So we appreciate all that they've contributed to the choir, and those were peer-selected awards. Let's give them one more round of applause. Next, we have the Trojan Pride Award, and the Trojan Pride Award is presented to a senior member of the choir who has shown dedication to the Dodgeland Music Program. And so, someone who I have had in choir for many years, a lot of these seniors I've had since they were middle schoolers, and so this year's Trojan Pride Award is awarded to Parker Herman. And before I give out the last two awards with these shiny little awards over here, I do want to recognize our seniors. So if you are a senior in this group, please raise your hand. We have quite a group. Some have been with me since sixth grade, others joined in seventh or eighth grade, others joined up in high school. But no matter how many years they were with us, they all contributed so positively to our group, and not just in the choir room, but also solo ensemble participation or being in the musical, in many other ways. We are so thankful for our seniors, and we will definitely miss them as they depart for whatever life brings them next. But on that note, I have two final awards here, and these are both the National School Choral Award. And I have two to give out this year, breaking with tradition, but with as many seniors as we have, and we have two very deserving recipients. So I'm gonna read to you, without revealing the name on the certificate here, I'm gonna read to you what it says. So the National School Choral Award, in recognition of singular merit, ability, and achievement of outstanding contributions to the success of the school vocal program, and of an unusual degree of loyalty, cooperation, and high qualities of conduct by the general consent of the music faculty, school officials, and others. So, first of all, our first recipient of the National School Choral Award really in their senior year blossomed and has accomplishments to show for it. Both of their solo ensemble pieces made it to state. And so our first recipient, if that didn't give it away over here, is Emma Verbaten. And our second recipient is someone who kind of went on a journey with choir and with our music program. Started in Vox, did some time in Vox. I had to twist arms and pull legs to get them to join Canto, where I thought their skills would really help the ensemble flourish. And lo and behold, this person is now pursuing a career in choral music education. So, want to recognize our second recipient, Rebecca Egebrecht. All right, I'm going to introduce our... Do we have an intro for our next song? For Parting Glass? Oh, that's right, I was going to do it. It's because it's sentimental. So this is a traditional Scottish song, traditionally sung by a group of friends after a gathering together. And the words are very sentimental. And for me, this piece is about our seniors. So it's about our seniors kind of, this is their last concert here with the exception of graduation. And so a chance to sing together, make beautiful music together. And so this one is dedicated to the seniors. This is The Parting Glass.
Oh, all the money that e'er I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me.
Our last song is River Song by Roger Emerson. This traditional song has Celtic roots and is based on Celtic celebrations. The four-part harmony along with the instrumental gives this piece life and spirit. We hope you enjoy our last piece, River Song.
And if you're not in a Celtic mood yet, you have a long intro to get there, so sit tight.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a pleasant evening and hope to see you back here tomorrow for our band concert.